everything is new again. Walking with the permagrin, head so high. I'm back with you and all is right. Shaking on the apple tree, ticking off the honeybees, watch them fly. It's just like we never said goodbye.
Hey guys, what's up? NihonTiger here. Welcome back to NeoCraft server. Today we are outside. Oh my gosh, I forgot a block up there. I'll have to get that one later. But we're outside of my lovely fortress because we have some work to do. Oh, so this must be what they've been working on. Oh, there's a giant ravine here. I never knew this existed. Wow. This is really cool. We'll have to poke around in here maybe at some point. But this is... this is all Rakuri's doing. This is really close to the surface, isn't it? Wow. I didn't realize it was that close to the surface. Never know what you can find, but Rakuri, I believe, has made a 3x3 tunnel that goes all the way back to my other station, which connects to the purple line. And so this will kind of be a little transfer line between here and my next big build, which I'm going to be doing with Fuchs and Rakuri possibly, which is the Katzegard Grand Central or Grand Terminal, something like that. It's a train station. Okay, it's a big old train station. So the big thing now is figuring out where all these lines are going to come together, and then, so let's see, 894, 49, 4, 11. So that's blue lines going to connect here. So trying to figure out the way to orient this. So we have... I kind of want to orient it. Let's see here. I'm going to start laying this out today. So that's really what we're going to do, is we'll talk about a few things and we'll lay out the station, kind of give you an idea of what we're aiming for, and just talk about a few things in life in general. So let me see here. I want to see. Road is here. So the road is at 1437. And then the hills are back here at 1479. Oh, hi. I'm just trying to see how much space I have to do this. So it's about 40 blocks. And then this side to side here. There's a witch over there. So from here, 1448 to... oh, wait, no. That's wrong one. I'm reading the wrong one. That is actually negative 263 to... please don't tell me it's going to be like exactly 300. Three or something. About 313. So it's about 50 by 40, maybe. So it's going to be longer this way. And that might be best, because what we want is we want to have... This way up the front will actually be... oh, the train station comes in this way too. So that's from the stronghold line. And we got another line that's going to come in that way. So I wonder, actually, if it's going to be best to orient it so that I kind of want to orient it so it's facing this way, because that way when you come up over the hill, it's the first thing you see is a big old train station right here, and then you see the build over there. But I'm wondering, I want to keep this hill here, but I'm wondering if it might be best to orient it that way. I don't know, because I feel like most people are going to come from spawn that way. This way is over towards other people's builds. So why don't we... let's plot this out. This is why we're plotting it out. We're going to use some cobble, just as markers for what we're going to do first before we destroy anything. So let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So the front, if we do the front should be here where this sign is. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There's a zombie chasing me. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Most of my diamond tools, by the way, are also kind of starting to break, so I may have to repair them. Off camera here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I just want to get an idea of the size of this before I start building. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. because I want this to be a big build, but I don't want it to be too big. I want it to make sense with the scale here. 3, 4, 5. I think this might be big enough. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Should be 18 by 18, right? So it should be 36, 37 blocks wide. Oh goodness, I've gotten all the zombies pissed off. I hate it. It rains all the time on multiplayer servers, and you get all these zombies and whatnot. Wonder if this server is in the Pacific Northwest. I made a joke about it raining a lot there, huh? But, get this guy out of the way. Thank you. Stupid skeleton. Where's my bow? There's my bow. Bow's also kind of getting worn down here. Everything's getting worn down. I haven't fixed it. But I don't want to do that in camera. So, size-wise, we're looking at... Let's see if we can maybe put one, two more on the ends here. I'll make it about 40 blocks wide. Which should be decent. One, two. And so yeah, this is just kind of the first basic process of figuring out the size of your build. For those of you who have never done this, and you just kind of like, oh, I'll just make the build as big as I want it to be. The first thing you should always do is just kind of get an idea for your size. So you know, you have to know your build space, and then you have to know kind of, kill all the zombies. And then you have to kind of know, within that build space, how much is space that going to take up? How is it going to look? I think that's a fine size. It's probably good. So then we can kind of have maybe, can we do three more on the side here? Because that way I can kind of do like a little bit of a recessed little wing area. I hope I can do this. 2, 3. It's going to be really close because it's going to eat up a little bit of space. So maybe I'll do two instead. But I've been really busy lately, so I'm sure a lot of you have... Oh, no, it's stopped raining. Thank goodness. Please burn to death. Or maybe it's not storming now? I don't know. Why is it not... why is it still raining? Which is dead, at least. So maybe we'll make this two... We can bring this in one. And that's how we'll get our three. But I've been really busy lately. I've got SMB now. As for those of you that haven't noticed, I've been invited to and have joined the SMB server. So that will be kind of a second Minecraft series that you'll see on my channel. And it's the first time I've had one in such a long time. I used to have Carnus Terra, but... And it's still an active server, but it's just, you know, I'm not recording on there anymore, and I'm not really playing as much because it's been a little quieter, I guess. But who knows? Maybe I'll pop in there on stream at some point or something. I'll have to finish a village build there sometime too. Oh, I should put some torches down. This is gonna be crawling with mobs otherwise. There we go. But, yeah, we really haven't gotten much done so far in, like, 9 minutes. But, yeah, I've got SMB now. I've got, NeoCraft is kind of... Things have kind of gone quiet there. But I've got some other projects that people have invited me to that I... Or people have said they might be interested in having me participate in that I'm considering at this point. There's a lot of stuff going on in the Minecraft world. There's also, you know, Minecraft Bingo. I've kind of gotten back into that, helping some people out with some troubleshooting and realizing, hey, this was pretty fun. Why'd I ever stop playing it? Mostly because I got busy. There we go. Get all of this lit up. But it's been really hectic for me, and there's a lot of games coming out too, and I want to play all these games, and I'm like, I don't have time to play all these games and do, you know, 1,000 videos, and more importantly, I think I've had the evidence of this that if I do like 1,000, like 5 videos a day, nobody watches them anyways. So, kind of dealing with that problem too. So, have this come 6, 7, I think. Oh, we're just kind of setting up the box here for our build. If you can call the box, I guess. Oh, off by a little bit. We can have this part actually be 4, 5. Have this be a little bit kind of more oblong. And the reason for that is you get these different shapes and it makes it look really nice. So, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And we'll just mark that there. We'll just bring this kind of out. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I think that's right. I can just kind of get rid of that. So we're doing all this stuff. We're doing it in symmetry because we want it to be a symmetrical build. Most train stations are symmetrical builds. And the idea of what we're going for here is 23. The idea for what we're going for here is we want to make this almost like a Victorian style train station. So it's actually gotta be like right here. So we're thinking like if you go to Europe and look at some of the really, really nice train stations, that the really old, really nice ones, kind of maybe even like, well, I can't remember which ones in Europe. Maybe, oh geez, was it Paddington Station or was it Victoria Station in London that originally based this off of? Some of the ones in like Eastern Europe as well, like in Berlin, Paris, and Munich. Those are some of the ones that I've been looking at for inspiration, and just that style of build I think will fit really well with what we've done so far in Katzegard. So hopefully we'll be able to do that without much difficulty. Hey, it stopped raining. Excellent. But now it's nighttime. Boo. So that's kind of what we're going for. And we don't necessarily need this to be a huge build. It can be a bit smaller than GAF Central because it will not be a... It will be a major station, but it won't be the big station. So it's fine if it's a slight bit smaller. Oh, I can actually put these blocks here, but it's been a project that I've wanted to work on for some time, and getting some other people to help me with it is going to be, I think, very, very important to actually getting it done. Because sometimes I build these projects and I build them by myself, and then I like right now I get wrapped up in a bunch of other things and then I don't get them done and I feel bad about it. Because I feel like I should be able to finish more of my build projects, and I do finish a lot of the creative build ones I do, but survival is always such a different beast, and it requires you to just have so much patience and so much time, and you have to spend a lot of time grinding and, you know, going, you know, down to mines to get materials, and it's just not always conducive to producing regular Minecraft content, especially if you find yourself being really, really busy. And this is kind of a point I find myself in right now. So let's see here. I'm just trying to figure out how big I want the platform, because we need to have a platform. So this is going to be the middle. The platform's got to come out. How big I want this main area to be. So like right here. And we'll kind of set up our main lobby now. This is the next thing we're going to set up. this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Make it even 11. We'll just kind of set up our lobby here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And that will give us some space to work with. Be able to add little rooms and just, you know, I think with train stations is that they're very much large buildings that are empty on the inside. So there's a few times, well, for the most part, I like to advocate against building these big empty structures. But there's a few times where that's possible. And the train station is definitely one where you can get away with building a big empty lobby because that's really what it is. And then so we'll just put these here just to denotate that's where that's going to go. And we'll put a couple of little markers here to kind of let people know when we start building that these are going to be separate little wings. Actually, I'm going to put this one wide. So if it looks like we're almost building a blueprint, it's kind of the idea of what I'm doing here is just plotting out a rough idea of where everything is going to go. So here is our kind of our front facade. And then we've got this big area where you come in, and there may be a clock up there. And there could also be a clock on the outside of the train station, too. Because clocks, they usually have the clocks on both the outside and the inside, and they're usually very large clocks. And then these are like tiny little wings over here, and this is kind of our main lobby. And then the trains, to actually get on the trains, or in this case, to get on the mine carts, you're going to have to come out here. Oh, hi. And we want to have, I think we want to have, let's have 4 or 5 lines. So here's our middle point, and we're going to want to have our platform here. Let's see here. So we've got 3, 5, 7, 9, 11. Okay, so it's 11 by 11. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, that seems there's a measure that's off here somewhere. One of these is too big because that should match up properly. And I think it's probably because of the furnaces and stuff. So I bet this one's off by one block somewhere. So I bet that's the case. I bet it's just slightly off. That's going to mess with the 1, 2. No, it's not. Did I build with an even number and not realize it? If I did, I'm going to kill myself. I'm going to kill myself, but I'm going to be angry at myself. Oh. So that's 3. This should be even. I mean, I duplicated this on both sides properly. And this is what? 2 and 3. Unless I went 3 and 3 on the other side. No, it's 2 and 3, so they should be the same. One of these just might be longer by one block. That's 3, and that's 3. Okay, so we have a mystery on our hands. This doesn't quite line up as well as I'd hoped, but we'll worry about that later. We'll get that figured out in the meanwhile. So this is just off. So we'll just keep this as it is, and we'll kind of make this side be the one that, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is actually over by one block. I wonder if I have an extra block over here. So we'll just have to bring everything in, perhaps in the future, but we'll go with this for now. So train platforms should be, I would say, be kind of a uniform length here. So let's do like 2, and then we'll have this one be 3 in the middle. And then we'll have 3 here, 2, 3, and then 4 here. Okay, so that's actually not going to work. What if we made this 2 from this wall, and had the middle one be 3? 1, 2. Okay, so if I do that, so we have 2, 2, And then this is going to be 2. So I'm just trying to figure out. I know the ones at the GAF Central Terminal are kind of like 2 or 3 wide. This is the difficult part, is actually getting all this planned out. Because right now I only have space for 4 lines up here. And I can always expand this out. I can make this go further out and whatnot. But it's difficult. We want to try and see what we can do here. So we got 3 here. And here, I think we got our train line. I'll have 2, 2. So let's try and do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then walls there. So that's 6 lines. That's actually pretty good space. I've got that there. And this is all, for those of you wondering if it's going to be built out of cobble, it's not going to be built out of cobble. It's going to be built out of various stones and whatnot as we figure out what we want design-wise. So it looks really ugly right now, and that's just kind of the way that planning goes out, and we have to plan these things. Oh, hit the T button instead of the E, or whatever. I hit the wrong button, but that's kind of the way when I'm planning these things out in survival. You've probably seen my other videos. They do kind of look a little ugly, and they're not gonna be pretty. I guarantee you that much. But 6 should be enough. I think 6 is going to be enough. Maybe we want to have this push out one more, like this one is over here. I don't know. We can always move, if need be, we can always move one of those blocks that way, perhaps. Do we have space to do that? Yeah, we have space to do that, I think. So we can always move this out here and then have this actually be 2 on the side. So I'll have to figure that all out later. But the main platform, I want to extend out to maybe here. And this will be, how many blocks will this be? It'll be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 blocks. I think that's decent. And then the back end will be kind of here. We'll just put some blocks down here to kind of note where the back end of this train station is going to be. So something like that. 1, 2, 3. And we'll just put a little marker here for now. So this is kind of our train station space. It's eating up most of the area that we had for growing trees. But at the same time, it doesn't actually eat into that forest over there too much, because it's more other people's area than it is mine. So let's kind of get up here. We can pillar up, can't we? I probably want to pillar up with something. I'll use a redstone. Redstone to pillar up because it breaks easier. But this is kind of a rough look at what our train station is going to look like. And I do have to take some screenshots, actually, because I want to kind of give some of the guys in the Minecraft thread over on GAF. I want to give them a little bit of an idea of what we're looking at here. So, boop, there we go. Nice and tidy. It's looking pretty good. So this is going to actually be, it's not going to be a huge build, but it is going to be a very, very large build when all things are said and done. And I have to also figure out how we're going to get all the lines here moved around. We may have to have some underground switching and stuff, because this is, like, the blue line's coming in from over there. You can see that's the blue line. The line from Katzegard West coming in from over there, wraps around over there. And then we've got another line that's going to be coming in from that direction down into here, which is why I actually oriented this way. So, yeah, it's looking pretty good so far. I mean, it doesn't look like much, but You can see we've actually got a little bit more space back there, too. If we want to extend the platforms out more, we can do that. But, yeah, as far as everything goes, I think this is a fairly good layout for what we want our space size consideration to be. And I'm pretty content with that. I'm pretty happy with the size of how this is going to look. I mean, it's big, but it's not overpoweringly big, and it's not really even bigger than, I think, GAF Central, which is fine. This just needs to be a decent sized train station. We'll play with this a little bit. I'll probably play with this off camera and adjust it and first off, I do have to adjust it because this doesn't line up properly, and I actually probably have to move this out. This side up, I'll have to count and make sure I've got all my stuff lined up. But we've got to start, and that's what's good, because people have been bugging me about starting this, and we've got to start. It's just an ugly cobble start. The next step for me, I think, is to figure out how to design the facade, what blocks I want to use in this build, how I want to have this done, because we could use quartz, but quartz is very, very hard to get to. I know for other people it's not so hard, but for me, it's always been really hard to find. So, that being said, we have a new project we're starting on. It will take shape here in the very near future. I'll be probably working on Fuchs and with Fuchs and Recruit, not working on Fuchs. Oh god, that's 10:30. But I'll probably be working with Fuchs and Rikui on this, and perhaps whoever else wants to jump in. I'll ask around and see if anyone's got some ideas. But it's gonna be really cool when it's done, and I promise you, it will be done. I would even say by the end of the year. So within the next couple of episodes, I'm sure you'll see some progress on this. I gotta take that giant. What's his name? Fanto or something? It's from Super Mario Brothers 2, but I gotta take that down too. It's nice, but it doesn't belong on my on the facade of my tower dry. And I know you put it up there. So, thank you guys for watching. As always, good luck, good mining, have fun, and I will see you guys next time here on the NeoCraft server. I am gonna go get this block down. Oh, and this is cool. I didn't realize that. I'm gonna leave this sign here because this is just. This is Undertale, and it's awesome. And I don't want to touch that. It's just too awesome. I love that. I love that game. Undertale's amazing. Where'd that damn block go? Hi, pig.